What?
Don't, it has to be in the store.
Yeah, honestly, yeah. I go with all reliable.
You can hunt 50 cal, but honestly, with 308, that caliber alone, it's more than likely to hunt, you'll be able to hunt any game, any animal in North America.
And I think it would be a success.
Yes.
All right, so listen. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna have a shop talk. We are gonna talk about what are, or what is their choices of hunting rifle. When I say hunting, I'm not talking about a huge game, but just, you know, hogs, deer, something that, you know, can take a average. Well, I guess you can shoot anything with anything. We all know that. So that's what we're gonna talk about today. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, there's 5 of us in here. So we're gonna have the top 5 choices of what we feel would be best to take out into the field to take down game. Got it? All right. Oh, and while y'all at it, go ahead and drop y'all choices in the comments so that we can discuss that too. All right, so over you last.
Oh, you always can put last.
Bevel. Okay, so you got to tell me. Let me come on the other side. So you got to tell me what you're choosing and why. Oh yeah, look, y'all. Look. I did bring donuts. So if you're not working on Sunday, I'm sorry.
But I think if I had to choose one rifle in the store. To go hunting with, I choose a Sig Cross.
Okay, now, is it in the store?
Yeah, it's right up there.
All right, Oompa. Oompa's gonna be the Vanna White. Even though he's not tall as she is.
I'm vertically challenged, but I'm horizontally gifted, okay?
Okay, so this will be Babel's option, the Sig Cross. Now, would you keep the same scope on it, or?
I'd probably change the scope and caliber. That one's 308.
Okay.
I own a 6.5, so I'm gonna wanna go with the 6.5.
Okay.
But I'd change up the scope to maybe a Vortex.
A Vortex loop?
Can you click down the loop?
Yeah, Vortex.
Yeah.
And why?
Just because I'm more familiar with the platform. I have Vortex and other long range stuff. And I like the scope clearer. And that one is just a little bit too small on the objective side for me.
Okay, let me see. And weight-wise, it looks like it's pretty light. Yes, it's lighter than I thought. And actually, the handguard, I like the fact that I can actually wrap my hand around the handguard. Rifle is clear.
Yeah. It's not also fold, so it makes it easy for backpacking.
Oh, yes, this is nice. The Sig Cross. Bevel is going with the Sig Cross, bolt action or semi-auto?
Bolt action.
Bolt action. And why?
Bolt action because I run close to breasts and I don't gotta worry about gas, failure feeds, failure to ejects. Grab that bolt, send it back, load the next one, and you're good to go. Less components to deal with.
Wow, in that type of situation.
Yeah, and I think they're more accurate.
You hear that?
Accuracy matters.
Accuracy matters, yes. And it is a very attractive piece.
And you can fold the stock if you ever want to throw it in a backpack, walk around.
Let me see how easy that is. Oh, I can do it. It is very nice. All right, so that's Bevel's choice. All right, so I'm gonna think, oh, I think you're up next. Kevin's busy. All right, so put that back. Okay, so Bill said Sig Cross chambered in 6.5 Grendel, Creemore, 6.5 Creemore with the Vortex scope, and he will have a can on it. So that's, did I cover everything?
Yeah.
All right. Are you ready? He didn't even want to. He didn't want to show y'all him pulling that down. All right. So this is Rogelio, A.K.A. Oompa. And Oompa, what is your choice?
I have to go with all-reliable. I'm going with the Remington R700.
Chambered in.
308. I love 308, opposite to Bebo. I'm more familiar with 308 due to the fact that with my experience of me hunting, 308, more than enough caliber size to take down any from mid to big game animal in North America. From moose to deer to hog or bear, it will take down anything.
This looks like it weighs a little more than.
Absolutely.
No? Well, it does
weigh
a little heavier. Let's do a quick beer check for y'all. It is clear. Does feel a little heavier, but it doesn't feel uncomfortably heavy. So if this was strapped on you, it would not. I don't think it would be an issue. So as far as sight wise. What would you use for size? It does look like it has the pick rail option where you can add the pick rail to it.
I would honestly, the same option as Bebo, I would go with a Vortex Optic because of the fact that I've used it in the past and they look so reliable well. And when you're out there hunting, depending on your terrain, these guns do get smacked on quite a lot. And with Vortex, their warranty is amazing. So if you just contact anything that happens to that Optic, when you're done with that trip, you give them a contact, they'll fix the problem right then and there.
I didn't know that. It's good to know. So we said 308, Remington 700, bolt action, obviously, with a Vortex scope. It feels nice, but to me, it's a lot front heavier than the Crocs. So this would be a tougher option for me to actually shoot standing.
Yes.
I would have to either shoot from a sitting position or with a bipod, tripod, or something.
Correct.
And is there a loop for it? It does not have a loop.
It does have a loop for the bipod right here.
Okay.
It's M-lock.
M-lock, right.
Another good
thing. And you can put a can on it too. Straight at barrel.
Another good background option on the 700. It has the background from both hunting and law enforcement. The Remington 700 has always been a good option for law enforcement snipers in the past as well.
Sniping?
Even to currently this day.
Wow, but it does have a nice padded butt stock on it. I like it. I might have to look into one of these. Very nice. All right, did I miss anything?
No.
Everything on there. Covered it all?
Covered it all.
All right, let me just pull this trigger. Trigger is pretty easy. All right, so put that. Cool. Kevin is still busy. But there's a lot of options. Now let me ask you this. Since we got a little bit of time, 12 gauge, shotgun options. Shotgun options for random hunting. I know you can shoot, hunt hogs with shotguns and, deer, you can use that for hunting purposes. If you had to choose one of those up there, what would you choose?
Hunting shotgun wise, I would go with the Benelli. Preferably for any kind of bird hunting, waterfowl, quail, everything like that. The Benelli is hands down.
It's very attractive too.
Oh yeah.
So this is 12?
This is 12 gauge. You'll hold 5 rounds, but depending on what state you're in and then what you're hunting, most wildlife organizations only allow you 3 rounds while you're hunting.
Okay. So that would be your first shot, follow-up shot, and
one more.
Just in case.
Yeah.
Okay. Depending on the state.
Yeah. With the waterfowl, you hear about 28-inch. You also have your external chokes, depending on what you want to, what you're most comfortable with. It already comes with the camouflage Cerakote, so it blends in well with the terrain. Especially here, this you can see with the camouflage here, this is meant more for waterfowl because you're more cornfield setting, as you notice here.
I do. I want to.
Yeah.
I want to. Oh, this is nice and light.
And it's light.
Yeah. I didn't do a quick gear check for y'all. Although he did, his rifle is clear. This one does feel nice. That is nice. Fiber optic front sight instead of your average pin front sight. I think that's nice. With that. Very nice. I like it. So now this is specifically waterfowl. So what if I want to hunt doves? Or
you can. Same gun you can. You just change same bird shot and you change a different range you want to go with. You would change the choke if you like. It all depends on your preference.
Okay, so it's all a preference thing. It's very nice. Very, 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 very nice. All right, so that's birds. We talking about hogs.
The good thing is about hogs, you can shoot them with the same thing.
Yeah, I don't think I want
to. But if you're going...
going all about it, then you can't go wrong with a Benelli M4.
Now, would you use what cartridge would you use?
Slugs. Slugs all day.
Yeah, I'm familiar with the Benelli M4. With a slug, would you add an additional scope on it, or would you use your iron sight?
I would put actually a red dot. Not a full-on optic, I would just simply go with your standard red dot optic. I can go either with either an EOTech or a Vortex red dot and call that a day. I'll be more than happy with that. Engagement distance with a hog, I would go anywhere from, say, 40 yards and up.
All right. Shotgun is clear. Nice. Benelli M4. This is what he would use on his hog. Kevin, before you get busy again,
yes.
Quickly, what is your hunting option and why?
Hunting option and why?
Yes.
Caliber.
No, I need rifle, I need caliber, I need scope, I need it all. And
I would say my Winchester Model 700.
Really? You too?
Faithful.
Because I have that.
Oh, faithful, baby.
The bolt is great. I have maybe what? My boy's been with me for like 12 years and they don't make me look more than I have. I'm not gonna lie, 308, Yoki.
Okay, so he's going with the exact same rifle style as.
Yo, what did Rohit choose?
He chose the Remington 300.
Oh no, mine is the Winchester.
Winchester?
I have the Winchester.
Oh wait, is it in the store?
Huh?
You have
to? No, I'm the only one that has it.
Okay, well listen. You gotta choose something.
It's in the store?
It's in the store.
Oh no, then the SIG, the SIG Cross, the 308.
Okay, so now he's choosing. Now we have two people that chose the same.
Because Bebo chose the same.
Yeah, Bebo chose the same.
And then he chose a Remington. All faithful.
Right. So, one more time, we're gonna just show it to you one more time. Put on the SIG Cross. So, and what caliber?
I think after this little, it's earned features on the channel.
Oh, so do you hear that? He wants to add that. So yeah, if y'all want to see the SIG Cross in action, let me know. Drop it in the comments, and we, depending on how many people vote yes, we will bring it to the channel. But you gotta vote yes.
Hashtag do it for Bebo.
Hashtag do it for Bebo. Yes. So
baby.
Do it what?
Do it for Bebo.
Hashtag Bebo worked for a SIG for the first time.
So. We have Kevin with the same option as Bebo. Right. So it's a SIG Cross chambered at 308 with what type of scope?
Loophole.
With the loophole? All right, with the loophole, and that's it. It is what it is. It don't get no easier than that.
So what you pick in the store?
What do I pick in the store?
That's a good one.
That's a good one, very good one. And it's give me a second. What I'm gonna do, we gotta get Ant first. Let me look and see, because I don't know the inventory, which I should.
Oh, you haven't even seen this stuff.
See, they're pulling out new stuff that I haven't even seen. It's a Danny. It's a Danny. Hmm. So, this could be, has nice weight to it. Feels good. I don't know. No, let me look. I don't want to go for an AR just yet. I'm not jumping head first for an AR right now. Let me look. Let me get Ant's opinion. Not even opinion. His choice. And
The site was like really, really dull, SKS, but he did. Same one, because I wasn't trying to compete. But I was trying to figure out where the actual like sites were, where the alignment was. And then when I found it, he was like, bro, you should like, you know, when I crap. I'm like, bro, I'm trying to figure out where this arrow is. Yeah, so it's been like, I've been helping like 3 years.
It's beautiful and it's accurate.
It's deadly accurate. It's deadly accurate.
Aim on?
The guy opened up like literally 2-inch hole at 23 yards. So
alright.
I don't think he's selling it though.
No, I mean, but I need to find one. And it looks like it's an older one. It's not even a new one.
But he kept it in really good condition. It looks, like, the finish is perfect. As if it just came out this
I'm gonna catch him when he comes outside. Well, anyway, that's not what I call looking for. Alright, I need to know in the store, if you can choose one hunting rifle in the store right now, what would you choose?
Hunting rifle.
Anything. Just pick it. Uh-oh, ain't going to this wall.
Don't put it out.
Oh no, and oh, you're cheating.
I knew you were going to go with that shit.
This
excessive ass.
That's what I'm talking about. And you know what? He beat me to it. That's what I was going to choose.
If I'm hunting, kill, that's what I'm going to kill. That's the gun out of the
I was going to choose the same thing, but Ant me. Okay, Ant. So tell me what it is, why you're going to choose it, what type of sight you're going to put on it.
Okay. To be honest with you, that's definitely overkill. So if I'm going to hunt, it depends on what I'm hunting.
Okay.
So, you know, end of the world.
Okay, hogs. Let's get a little bit more specific.
Okay.
All right. Okay, we're hunting hogs, we're hunting deer, we're hunting, like, medium game.
Okay, if I'm hunting medium game, then I do the Rum T700.
Okay.
I do the Rum 700. Just to keep it light, just to keep it classic. You know, so I like her. I like it a lot. Just keep it simple.
What? Chambered in what?
308.
Chambered in 308. What type of option?
Actually, this one is a 6.5 Creedmoor. And 6.5 Creedmoor.
Yeah, the 308 is over here.
6.5 Creedmoor, I'd take this one as well. It's getting popularity as far as the caliber. It maintains good ballistic coefficient, so energy downrange. Pretty good. Yeah, I'd put maybe. Man, there's so many options.
What's your fave?
Night Force.
He is irritating. And he going for the chill. If this was anything to where he had to just, okay, yo, if I tell him, Ant, whatever you want, I got you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want something I can see very well at in that distance. I want to see very well at distance. I know, Bevel said something. Well, that's good, because you know, they say when it comes to hunting, it's usually all about the optics, so. If I'm trying to get something downrange and I'm trying to get effectively and trying to see exactly, pick up a lot of information as far as the target, what I'm trying to get, this is what I look for, you know.
Quite simple, classic hunting rifle. I mean, it's not even no bells. When he went this way, I was like, I thought he was going to grab one of these lever actions.
No, lever?
Let me tell you, I was going to go for it. That's what I was gonna do, but I wouldn't think we were that much like-minded.
That's not hunting, that's obliterating.
Well, you said hunting. Hunting to do what? To kill or to eat? You know, I mean, to kill and eat. But if we're just doing it to kill, BMG. If we're gonna kill and eat, it's fine. So that's exactly what I would go for. So it's one of my go-to guns. I mean, it's a classic look.
Let me see how heavy it is.
You're right.
Very lightweight.
Oh,
it's a classic look.
Super light.
I mean,
super light.
You know?
Well, is a little stickier than the Remington.
Well, yeah.
A lot more stickier.
You know what's funny? I was going for the look. It looks classy, you know? It's a classy look. That's what I was going for.
Clear.
Yeah, we can't reload on YouTube, right?
But, I mean, it wouldn't be a look for me, but I guess it would get it done.
If you were on the farm, hunting hog, you had a nice,
I'll look around,
you know, 50 power tone right on there, and you're hunting. I people would just compliment the gun, like, oh my god, what kind of gun is she shooting? That gun looks so good. You get a lot of positive.
I was looking at this one.
You know, I mean, if you shoot the air at 10, you get a lot of positive. But this, any compliments, you're welcome. I'm the reason.
Classic.
Yes, but I like it a lot. This is my go-to gun. I like it. I really do.
All right, so Ant is choosing the
Remington
700, chambered in 6.5 Creedmoor with the Vortex scope and bolt action.
No, Night Force scope.
Night Force scope, sorry.
Yes.
And
go hard or go home.
Bolt action.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Understood.
So it's like your grandpa's rifle, but with my.
Look at Grandpa's face! Okay, so let's come over here because we really got to make some adjustments here. So the thing was, I asked everybody in the store if they had the ability to choose one rifle in the store to take hunting with them, what would it be and why? Okay, now y'all know I'm real extra. Let's do a quick clear check. She's clear. This is what I would choose. It is an absolutely beautiful rifle to begin with. It's just 50 cal. I'll definitely put a night fork on it. And I can shoulder it. So this is definitely
what's the difference from this one and the one you got?
This one has a shorter barrel, and it's the weight difference. There is a weight difference between the two. There is, but I can tell you that this one is shorter. I can prove to you that it's shorter because I can put this up to my shoulder. And I can hold it up. I can't do that with mine, even though it's still pretty short. But I can't do it with mine. But I can definitely get some shots off. So you know this got to come home. This got to come home. And I wouldn't be strapping it to my back or anything, so I'll definitely be shooting prone, and I will almost guarantee you that whatever it is I'm shooting will not get away. We're definitely taking home or taking it home. What do you think? What would be your choice of hunting rifle if you had the ability to just create or put a rifle together? Oh, yes. Okay, if you had the ability to put something together and your dream hunting rifle, what would it be? Drop that in the comments. Let's talk about it. And don't forget, hashtag do it for Bibble. If you want to see the Sig Cross on the channel, hashtag do it.
Hashtag, come on, let's do it.
Ay, te quiero preguntar que lo quiero ver. Por favor, si me dejas. This is the SKS. This is the owner of the SKS, and that it's absolutely beautiful. Okay, so everybody should be putting their little stuff in there, and don't forget to vote if you want to see the Sig Cross on the channel. It has to be hashtag do it for Bebo or yes or something in there. Look at his face. He's like, come on guys,
please.
Do it for Bibble. So, yo, again, y'all already know I love y'all for life. Thank y'all for joining me on this. What are we gonna call this? We're gonna call this Shop Talk Volume 1. So stay tuned for Volume 2. Y'all already know I love y'all for life. Peace.